These small cube type carburetors, found both on 2 and 4 stroke small engines, can seem a little bit daunting to work on. In my videos, I hope to bring to light just how easy it really is and instill that confidence in you to do so yourself at home. In today's video, I'm going to cover one of the most common mistakes that people make when servicing and rebuilding these carburetors at home. Of all the parts that can be removed and replaced to service one of these carburetors, there is one that requires an essential adjustment before it's going to work properly. Inside the metering chamber on one of these carburetors, which is the side that meters and supplies fuel to the engine when it's running, you'll find what's called a metering lever. This is a forked tab that holds, opens, and closes the fuel inlet needle. And on the other side, there's a tab. And between the two, there's a pin which allows the metering lever to pivot, opening and closing the fuel supply. And as you pull the throttle on your engine, it creates a vacuum inside the venturi of the carburetor, which is felt inside the metering chamber. This draws down what we call the metering diaphragm. It presses against the tab of the metering lever. That lifts the needle up and it supplies fuel in a monitored way inside the metering chamber and then on to the engine. To ensure the correct fuel flow and quantity of fuel inside that metering chamber for the engine to run correctly, we need to ensure that the lever tab is set to the correct height. The metering lever height is different in every carburetor, and also it doesn't come set from the factory. Therefore, if you simply install that lever like for like and replace the one that was in there, it's not going to supply the fuel correctly to the engine, and you're going to end up having running issues because of it. And I can't emphasize enough, regardless of the carburetor, who made it, or the style, this adjustment must be made, checked, and set any time that the lever is replaced. So what you'll need to be able to measure the height of the lever are these. They are metering gauges. They're just stamped pieces of metal supplied by the manufacturer of the carburetor that you're working on, and you'll find all across them the different models of carburetor that you can use to set them. Each carburetor is different, each manufacturer has a different set height, so there isn't one measurement across the board that you can use. So in this case, I have a Woolbro carburetor, so I need my Woolbro gauge, and I'm going to look on the side of the carburetor to find the model. In this case, it says WT, and therefore I look onto the gauge to find WT, and it's this small protrusion in the middle of the W itself. It's important that we remove the diaphragm and the gasket, and that there's no gasket material left on the surface of the metering side of the carburetor, as that can affect your measurement and the height in which we're going to set it. We rest the gauge on the body of the metering chamber, and we pass that gauge back and forth to see whether or not it will contact the metering lever. If we find that the metering tab is below the height of the gauge, then we're going to need to raise it. And if we find that the tab is bumping against the gauge itself, therefore we're going to need to lower it. We want the slightest amount of contact between the two and no more. To raise the lever, if it's too low, you simply place a screwdriver underneath that tab and then prise and bend it up. And then to lower that metering lever, if it's too high, gently press down onto the tab first with a screwdriver, and then with another screwdriver, press down onto the needle or the forked end of that metering lever and bend that back down. These levers are a wear item, and over time, from the contact of the nipple on the metering diaphragm against that tab, can cause a recess to form. With that tab having that worn recess in it, you can think you're setting the metering lever to the correct height using the gauge, but actually it's being set a little bit lower. And in doing so, it's going to require more vacuum from the engine before the metering diaphragm contacts that lever and fuel is supplied. And because of that, you're going to find that your engine's going to run leaner. If the tab of your metering lever is set too high, it's going to allow more fuel into the chamber, and thus your engine is going to run richer. And if it's set too low, it's going to allow less fuel in the chamber and your engine's going to run leaner. Each part of this carburetor works in unison with another. And in this case, there is a contact between the metering diaphragm and the tab of the lever itself. Actually, in fact, it's not the diaphragm that contacts that tab. It's called a nipple. The height of that nipple changes from diaphragm kit to diaphragm kit, and therefore we have to measure that as well. So if you've accidentally brought the wrong kit for that carburetor and you don't know to check the height of that nipple, you can end up running the engine again too rich or too lean, even if you set the tab of the metering lever correctly. Far from ideal, but I have on a number of occasions taken a file and gently removed some material from that nipple to then match it up with the diaphragm that I've removed from the carburetor. You can use your vernier calipers to determine the height and therefore match it up to the one that you've removed. Much better to use the right diaphragm, but knowing ways around obstacles is always handy and it can get you out of a pinch. And now you know how to set the height, you're ready to tune the carburetor. And I've got this video up here, which is Stihl's official tuning process for all their two-stroke engines. And it's the same process regardless of the manufacturer of that engine. Therefore, it's going to work on Husqvarnas, Echo, Shindawa, Kawasaki, Honda. It's all the same. I hope you enjoy that video. And until next time, I'll catch you soon.